Down. should get this party started.
That has had, as I'm sure most of you know, a fairly complex and convoluted emotional history. And it's actually been kind of cool. It's worked in our favor. You know, we take breaks. We take long breaks sometimes. And every time we come together, it's different. Every time we come together, there's a sense of new possibility. And so this time, when we got together at rehearsals, we said, let's just go out there and have fun. And we said to each other, let's go out and let's do the songs that we all love. And hopefully those are the songs that you love too. So we are most pleased to be here tonight. We are most pleased to see all of you here. Hope you have a great time!
Away, I feel sad. The dream. have. When I was just going to be a senior in high school, my family got transferred from Los Angeles up to San Francisco. And one day, I met Lindsey Buckingham. I was a senior and he was a junior. And I didn't see him again for 2 years. And he and his band called me for whatever, I don't even know what reason, called me and asked me to be in their band. And so all of a sudden, I was in this really great band, and we were smack dab in the middle of the greatest musical scene, in my opinion, of all time. San Francisco, Haight-Ashbury, Jimi Hendrix, Janis Joplin. We opened for all these bands, so we had this experience before we came into Fleetwood Mac. We actually had that experience. And so this next song was written about my memories of that time between 1968 when I joined Lindsey's band and 1971. And so when I talk about the Velvet Underground, I'm talking about San Francisco. So I'm back to the Velvet Underground, back to the floor that I loved, to a room with some lace and paper flowers, back to the gypsies that he and I were.
Away.
of people in this world. Winners, losers. But I lost my power in this world. But I didn't lose it. So I go insane, like I always do. And I call your name. She said, I'm like you. Two kinds of trouble in this world. Living, dying. When I lost my power in this world, and the rumors are flying. So I go insane, like I always do. And I call your name. She said, I'm like you.
Thank you.
For this next song, if memory serves me right, which it does not always, but I believe it does in this case, this song was the first one that we recorded for the Rumors album. And I guess the thing, at least in my opinion, the thing that makes the Rumors album stand up so well today is that obviously we were going through personal turmoil, and I think as individuals we had to reconcile a great many emotional opposites to get through that process, if only for a short time. And this song certainly has its share of those. It's actually, at its base, quite a sad song, but on top of that there is humor, there is optimism, and certainly a good share of aggression. This is called Secondhand News.
Yeah!
is going away.
Stay with me while
Well, this next song is very significant to me for a few reasons, and I think they all have to do with change. The song was first an ensemble piece, and it has since made its way to the stage as a single guitar and voice piece, and that change was kind of a profound one for me. But I think more importantly, the lyric of this song, when it was written, certainly it kind of accurately described the person that I was then, and it now is only an echo of that. And so I guess the song perhaps was once a reflection of alienation, and it is now a reflection of the power of change.
Before yesterday, I spent a couple hours with a very fine shoemaker here from your town who's going to make me a beautiful pair of comfortable, soft black leather boots. So I would like to dedicate this next song to him. Yuri, this is for you. It's called Landslide. Thank you. That we wanted to do one song that we had never done on stage before since 1975. So we went back through all our millions and millions of songs and decided to do this next song. It is a stormy song about stormy people in stormy relationships with some very deep, stormy problems. We like to call it, "I've Always Been a Storm."
Feel
I'm
help get it, baby. Just when I thought it was over, you know you got me. come in. I can't see, I ain't pretty, and my legs are thin. But don't ask me what I think of you. I might not give the answer that you want me to. He'd understand. He said, "Stick by me, and I'll be your guiding hand." Don't ask me what I think of you. I may not give the answer that you want me to.
You can go your own way. you so much. Thank you so much, one and all. And us up here on stage in Fleetwood Mac would like to take an opportunity to make some guys and girls sharing the stage with us tonight most welcome. Starting on background vocals, Miss Laurie Nix. Miss Shayna Anderson. Miss Sharon Salani. Oh yeah. On guitar and vocals, Mr. Neil Haywood. On keyboards, guitar, and vocals, our dear friend, Mr. Brett Tuggle. Let's hear it! Woo-yah! The next three people that I'm up here and we're all sharing the stage together, but I can tell you it is absolutely a pleasure to share the stage with the following people. Once again, on guitar and vocals, the maestro, the man with the magic fingers, Mr. Lindsay Buckingham! This lady certainly makes sure all of us guys behave extremely well. Our Lady of Fleetwood Mac, our First Lady, Miss Stephanie Nix. On my right, on bass guitar, making me sound good from 1967 to this very day, the backbone of Fleetwood Mac, Mr. John McVie!
One, two, three, four.
You guys were a complete pleasure to be with tonight. Thank you all for coming. We will see you next time.
What a rockin' great audience you have been. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We have had a ball! There's a couple of things us up here in Fleetwood Mac like to leave you with. One is take care of yourselves, and more importantly, take care of one another. We love you so much.